Data integration lets you load external data files to Oracle EPM Cloud. You create a file-based data integration, map dimensions and members, and set integration options before running it. In this video, you learn how to set file-based integration options and run the integration. I've already created an integration and added dimension and member mappings. Now, let's set options and run the integration. For more information on creating file-based integrations and mapping dimensions and members, view the related videos in the workflow. Data integration guides you through a workflow to complete data management tasks. Navigate between tasks by clicking a task on the workflow bar or next in back buttons. In options, you can select general and target options for your data integrations. General options include file information. For a file-based source, you can load data to a single period or a range of periods. You can load to multiple periods using different methods. One method is to create a file for each period and append a period name or period key to the file name. When you run the integration for a range of periods, the system constructs the file name for each period and uploads it to the appropriate POV. Another way is to include amount columns for multiple periods in a single data file. Category and period settings associated with a file may use predefined values. These settings may restrict the options available when editing selections. For target options, choose options specific to a location, such as the load method, batch size, whether to enable the drill region, or select any purge options. Target options selected here are dynamic and local to the specific target application. I'll save and close my integration. Here's my data integration. Before I run the integration, I'll open a form to display the data intersection I'll be loading to. The data point of view is set to plan scenario, working version, and the current fiscal year. My data load file contains January expense data for airfare, car rental, accommodation, and meals. Let's return to the data exchange to run the integration. For import mode, I'll accept the default selection. Replace. This option clears all the data for the POV in the workbench. For export mode, I'll select the default option, merge. This option overwrites existing data with the data in the load file. If data does not exist, it loads the new data. Select a start and end period. For a single period integration, the end period is selected automatically. Verify that the correct file is selected. Then run the integration. Click refresh until the status displays a green check mark. Let's look at the data in the workbench. Here's the data from my source file. Now, let's verify that the data is loaded successfully. Data from the source file was loaded successfully to the expense account. Check the links in the description for videos on first tasks in the data integration workflow. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.